Hello students, welcome to the video lecture on machine learning. In the last video, we have started with the module number 3, that is artificial intelligence and neural networks. So here we have also already discussed about what is neural network, what is the concept of artificial neural network, and I have explained about the where this term neural network is derived from. The neural network term is derived from neurological word, that is product, a biological word, that is product, neuron, which is like a brain cell. In the last video, I have already discussed about this. Then I have given a short introduction about the artificial neural network and what are the techniques or what are the algorithms that we are using in this neural network. And one of the popular algorithm, that is back propagation algorithm. And then I have discussed about the biological motivation behind the neural network. I have explained what is the brain cell, that is neuron, how many brain cells are there in the human brain, approximately how many are interconnected with each other, what is the switching time, or what is the time of connection, or what is the time of sending a message from one neuron to another neuron, that is called a switching speed, and how that switching speed is compared to the machine's switching speed. Okay, so all these things I have explained in the last video. So I request all of you to go through the last video to understand what is the biological motivation behind the artificial neural network. Okay, so in the last video I have just mentioned about one of the very important neural network application, that is called as ALBINN. Okay, so that is called as artificial land vehicle in neural network. Okay, so it is here ALBINN, artificial land vehicle in neural network. So artificial land vehicle is nothing but this is a example of driverless car. Okay, so already you might have seen different videos of driverless car in the YouTube channel, how this car is drive from one place to another place without having any driver. Okay, so it is one of the best example of artificial neural network. Okay, so how this things takes place? Okay, it is explained, it is first time introduced by a scientist, a neural network scientist by the name Palmer Liu in the year 1993. Okay, so how he has developed this system, you can see here. So he has taken a neural network input of a 30 cross 32 grid pixel. Okay, 30 cross 32 is nothing but 30 rows and 32 columns. So with the and in that grid or in that car, you can consider it as a car with this much input value. Okay, so a camera is mounted on the car, front of the car. Okay, a camera will be mounted. So what's the job of this camera? This job of this camera is to take the picture of the front rear view for each minute. Okay, for each millisecond, I can say it as a millisecond. For each and every millisecond, the camera is to take the picture of the front rear. You can say the road is there. Okay, so a car will be here. Okay, consider this is a car. A front of this car, a camera is mounted here like this. Okay, right. So this camera will take the picture of this front view. Okay, for every 5 minutes, you can say for every for every millisecond, it will take the picture. Okay, so based on this picture which is taken by the camera which is mounted on the car, your input will go to the wheel, the steering, and also to the input system of the car. Okay, the input will go to steering first. Okay, what this neural network will do is it will take the picture and it will process the picture. Okay, and if any obstacle is there, it will tell, or the algorithm is written in such a way that the car has to slow down or it has to stop if any obstacle is there in the front. Okay, otherwise consider on the right side some vehicle is moving. Okay, it also instructs the steering to take left, okay, and drive, because left side the road is empty, right side there is a vehicle. So like this, this system will work, and we will see, let us see how that system is connected and how this system is working. Okay, the network output is a direction. Okay, look at this. What is the output of this network, ALVINN network? It's a direction in which the vehicle is steered. Okay, suppose on the left side vehicle is coming, so the steering will be done at right side. In the right side, suppose some vehicles are coming, then the steer will be on left side, like this. Okay. So ANN is trained, artificial neural network is trained to mimic observed steering commands of human driving the vehicle for approximately 5 minutes. Okay. ALVINN has used its learned network to successfully drive at the speed up to 70 miles per hour. Okay. So this practically this system is there, and they have tested this system. Then the car, driverless car, has moved up to the speed of 70 miles per hour for a distance of 90 miles on a public highways. Okay, so this much with the speed and this much distance it is covered. So figure 4.1, I'll show you the figure. Yeah, this is actually the practical implemented car. This is the camera which is mounted on the car on the front, so it will take the picture of the road. So based on the picture, so it will process that image, and that image, process image, will be sent to the steering system. So according to the process image, if anything is coming on the left, so the steering will be turned towards right, or if anything is coming towards right, the steering will be towards left, and then if any obstacle is there, the driver, the car will be slowed down or it may be stopped. Okay, so all this is based on the neural network, artificial neural network. So this illustrates the neural network representation used in one version of the ALVINN system, and illustrate the kind of representation typical of many ANN systems. Okay. The network is shown on the left side of the figure with the input camera image depicted below it. So input camera is here. So as I said, it will take the frontier view of your car. So frontier is nothing but the road. This input is of size 30x32. That input will be given to the four hidden layers, okay, which is there, and hidden layer will process the input, and then these are the outputs. Okay, 30 outputs will be given. 30x32 is the input size. Hidden layers, four hidden layers are there which will be processing this. And then this is the output. Okay, 30 output units are there. Okay, so it works like this. Suppose if any obstacle is there here in the middle, so what happens is this value will be low. Okay, middle value will be low and left side value will be high. It will calculate the values. If any obstacle is there in the middle, then it will instruct your machine that at the middle there the value will be low and at the left side the value will be high, so saying that you have to steer towards left side. Okay, or if any obstacle is there on the right side, that time also it will give the low value to the right side and then high value to the left side, so that steer can be go towards or move towards left side. If any obstacle is there on the left side also, then it will give low value, or it will assign lower value to the left side and higher value will be assigned to the right side, so that car can be steered towards right side. So like this the system will work here. Okay, steering according to the direction of the steering the car will move. Okay, right. So each node in the network diagram corresponds to the output of a single network unit, and the lines entering to the node below it are the input. Okay, so these lines are nothing but input given to this nodes, four nodes. Okay. As can be seen, there are four units that receives the input, that is called as hidden layer. Okay, four units. Input directly from all 30 cross 32 pixel image. Okay, already I have explained about this image. These are called as hidden units because their outputs are available only within the network. It is called as hidden layer because the outputs are available only within the network. Okay, so hence it is called as hidden layer and is not available as a part of global network output. Okay, the output is only available within the network. It is not available outside the network. Hence it is called as hidden layer. Okay, four hidden layers are there in the picture. Each of this four hidden layer computes a single real valued output based on the weighted combination of 960 input. Okay, so you can see how it is 960 input because the image size is 30 cross 32. Okay, so 30 cross 32 is nothing but 960 input. Okay, right. So all this combination of 960 inputs will be calculated by hidden nodes, four hidden nodes. And these hidden units output are used as a input to the second layer of 30 output. Okay, as you can see in the example, this is a four hidden nodes. It will calculate some value and this becomes an input for all this output, 30 outputs. Okay, so for this outputs, the input is from four hidden layer. Each output unit corresponds to a particular steering direction. Okay, so if weight of this, okay, each of this nodes are nothing but the value of steering. Okay, this is left side, this is straight value and this is a right side value. If this node value is very high, that means car will be moved towards left. Okay, that means others are having low value and only these nodes are having high value, then car will be moved towards left. If this node is having very low value, center node's values are very high, then car will go straightly. If both the values are very low and this node's values are very high, then car will move towards right. Okay, steering will be towards the right, hence car will move towards the right side, right direction. Okay. Right. The output values are units determines which steering direction is recommended most strongly. Okay, based on the value, we can suggest to the car that on which side it has to move. The diagram on the right side of the figure, it depicts the learned weights value associated with one of the four hidden units in the ANA. The large matrix of black and white boxes on the lower right depicts the weight from 30 cross 32 pixel input into hidden unit. Okay, the large black and white boxes on the lower right, as you can see here. So this is lower right. Okay, large white and black boxes, it depicts that, okay, the weight of one of the hidden nodes. Okay, or one of the out of four, one has given this output. Okay, here white box indicates the positive weight and black box indicates the negative weight. Okay, so this white box, these are indicating positive weights, and the black box, these are indicating negative weights. Okay, so wherever the negative weight is there, that means there is an obstacle. Okay, so wherever the positive weight is there, there is no obstacle, as you can see in the figure. So obstacles are more towards the left side. Okay, on the straight side there is not many obstacle, and also right side there is no many obstacle. Hence, the car has to move towards straight direction. Okay, it has to move straightly on. So next, here the smaller rectangular diagram directly above the large matrix shows the weight from the hidden unit to each 30 output units. The network structure of ALV INN is typically of many ANNs. Here the individual units are interconnected in the layers that form a directed acyclic graph. Okay, so each individual units are interconnected with each other. Suppose, for example, there are four nodes. Okay, here 5 nodes are there. Okay, hidden 4 nodes are there here. Outputs, each of these are interconnected like this. Okay, so this forms your directed acyclic graph, because if you draw like this, each of this are interconnected with each other, then it looks like a directed acyclic graph. Okay, like this. In general, ANN can be a graph of many types of structures, acyclic or cyclic, directed or undirected. Okay, ANN is nothing but artificial neural network is nothing but, it's a graph of many type of structure. So it can be acyclic or cyclic, or it can be directed or undirected. So this is an example of figure that just now I have explained. Okay, so this is the output of weight, one hidden nodes output. Okay, white box indicates positive value, black dots indicate negative value. I think this is clear to all of you. Okay. So let us see what is ANN neural network. Okay, what are the problems that may occur in the artificial neural network? Just a second. Okay. So in the artificial neural network, there are most of the problems are with the training data corresponds to noisy complex sensor data such as input from the cameras and microphones. So most of the problems that may occur while taking the input is we may take the noisy inputs, or we may take some complex data from the cameras and microphones. So in such cases, the ANN will be very helpful for us. Okay, ANN, artificial neural network, is very helpful for us to reduce the noise or to reduce the complexity present in the data. Okay, whenever we have any noisy data or any complex data from cameras and microphones, we can apply ANN, artificial neural network, where it is well suited for this kind of problems. Okay, this is also applicable to the problem which are more symbolic representations are often used. So whenever more symbolic representations are used, such as decision tree, okay, so it is represented by three kind of symbol. So in such cases, we can apply our artificial neural network so that we can get the correct output. In these cases, ANN and decision tree learning often produces the result that is comparable accuracy. So in such cases, we can apply artificial neural network along with the decision tree to get the most accurate result. Okay, and the most commonly way we can apply the ANN are in the following problems. The first problem where we can apply ANN is instances are represented by many attribute value pair. Okay, so consider if one attributes are there. For example, I'll take one attribute as wind value, which we have taken in a previous example, wind value. For wind, many attribute pairs are there. For example, it may be a wind is slow, wind is fast, average, like this. Many attribute pairs are there. And you can consider another attribute that is air pressure. Okay. And it also contains many attribute values. In such cases, the complex data becomes very, very complex. Okay. Hence, we can apply our ANN, artificial neural network, to solve such kind of instances, attribute pair values. Okay. So the target function to be learned defined over instances that can be described by a vector of predefined features such as pixel values in the ALB INN example. The input attributes may be highly correlated or independent of one another. Input values can be any real values. Okay. So wherever the instances are represented by any number of highly correlated or independent values, then we can apply the artificial neural network to get the accurate or to get the target function. Okay, to achieve the target function. Next, second one, The target function output may be discrete value, real value, or a vector of several real or discrete valued attributes. So whenever the target function is of discrete value, a real value, discrete values are nothing but it's a combination of 0 and 1, real values are nothing but real numbers, and the vector of several real or discrete valued attributes. In such cases, we can apply the artificial neural network where the combination of number is from either 0 or 1, or it may be real value number or vector of any real and discrete valued attributes. So we can apply this example to ALB NN also, because the steering direction is based on the real number only. That is, 0 means it will not go into that direction, or negative number means it will stop the car, and positive number means it can move in that direction only. Then the training data, a training example may contain some error. Okay, so sometimes the training example or training data may contain some error. So our ANN system, that is artificial neural network system, is very good to remove such kind of errors from the training data. Hence we can apply ANN where it contains error. Long training times are acceptable. Okay, so some system may not accept this long training times, because if you give long training times of many hours, so the algorithm or the output may be, the result may take time to give accurate result, or it may also happens that the system end up in hang state. Hence during such cases we can apply artificial neural network where the longer training times for is required. For example, if we say decision tree learning system, if the training example is very very high, then we can apply artificial neural network so that we can get the accurate result based on the training example. And whenever the fast evaluation of learned target function is required, then also we can apply the artificial neural network. Okay, so if you want any function which is very complex, target function which is very complex, and we want the function to be evaluated very fastly in order to get the accurate output, hence we can apply the artificial neural network in such cases. Example is again ALV-ILN, which is a complex network where the target function calculation is very complex. Okay, so hence we can apply our artificial neural network during such cases. And last one, the ability of human to understand the learned target function is not important. So the weights learned by the neural network are often difficult for human to interpret. Okay, the learned neural network is less easily communicated to the human than learned rules. So whenever the calculations are very difficult for human to interpret, then in such cases we can apply artificial neural network so that it can learn the values very easily. So these are the problems that we can address by using artificial neural network. Okay. Right. So this is the end of class. In the next class we will discuss about the perceptron. This is the basic unit of artificial neural network system. So we will discuss what is perceptron and what are the different ways where we can represent the perceptron. Okay. Thank you, and please watch the video carefully.